Hi, I'm Nikki Terrio here at Gallery 78 with artist Francis Wishart. This is his new exhibition opening today on October 2nd, 2015. It runs until October 25th, and it's called Hymn to the North Shore. Now, Francis has he's got his collection of art in the Metropolitan Museum of Art, as well as the Museum of Modern Art in New York and the Victoria and Albert, and he is here with some of his new work. So tell me first, when did you become an artist, and
Well, really from a very young age, because I was brought up with the smell of turpentine when I was very little, because my father, my stepfather, my mother were all artists. And as I used to go to school, boarding school, when I came back for holidays, I would go and spend time with my mother, and that would be out. She would always be out drawing. She's the artist and dance. And I'd be going out, and therefore I'd take a drawing book or borrow one from her, and I would be drawing, and that's when really it all started. Okay. It started me on drawing, it started me as an artist, but it also started me my environmental interest, because I was really the first things I drew were trees.
And now your technique, monotypes, these were invented in the 1600s in black and white, and then Degas used them in the 1800s, and we don't really see many people using this now. So why did you go
right.
to the monotypes?
Well, as you quite rightly said, Degas, 1900s, 19th century,
yes.
he did them all, and he's famous for them, these black and white ones of girls undressing and taking washing and all those things. It then sort of petered out, but artists have always used them a bit. I started them about 15, 20 years ago, and because I used to etch a lot, which was similar in the sense that you're painting on a steel plate,
yes.
Would be zinc or copper.
Yeah.
I then started doing these monotypes because you can do them relatively fast, and you can get a completely different texture. And gradually I went on to color monotypes, which is a very, rather difficult technique.
Okay.
It's very difficult the way I do it, because a lot of people still do colored monotypes, but they mix up the colors and it's slightly more abstract. Doing it as controlled as I do it is really quite difficult.
Okay.
And anyone can do it, but it takes years to learn.
Right.
To do it properly.
Exactly, yeah. Okay. Now, as we see that with the subject matter here, what is it about the northeast of this beautiful province that inspires you?
Well, because when I was about 14, that's when I first came to New Brunswick, and that's when I first, because my grandparents and great-grandparents were from New Brunswick, from Bathurst, and I immediately fell in love with it. Or at that age, I was enjoying fishing, I was enjoying the rivers, the lakes, the sea, the Bay of Chaleur,
yeah.
And it all seemed so magical to me from a European point of view. And ever since, I've come every year, and I try and stay as long as I can, so 3 months a year sometimes. And it's still magical. And in this particular show, I think I wanted to it was an expression of love for New Brunswick, and also wanting to show the poetic side of New Brunswick, because of North Shore, because often it's associated with all the big industries, mining,
right.
Forestry, fishing, and it's that rather tough side, economic side of things. And I try to show, with this show, I'm hoping to show the more fragile, the more sensitive, the more poetic side of it.
Okay, that's beautiful. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you.